Hello, welcome to Ekidel. We are training for civil and structural engineering. My name is Justice Onwaka and I am your instructor. Today, I will be showing you the design of a connecting beam on a pipe foundation. So by the end of this lesson, you will be able to know how to design a connecting beam for your pipe foundation. Okay, as you can see right now, this structure is basically a six-story building plus the ground floor, that makes it a seven-story building. So, and this structure is sitting on a pipe foundation, as you can see that, and the length of the pipe foundation is 18 meters based on our design and based on the soil, on a soil report. So right now, I'll take you right now to the foundation plan. So right now, on the foundation plan, as you can see right now, this is now our pipe caps. Let me just turn on this my grid line. Okay, and then you can see all our pipe caps now. The reason why I turned it off is for you to see it very, very clearly. So let me just turn it off again. So you can see that we have different pipe caps, as you can see, they are based on the load coming on the column. As you can see that each of the columns here has different loading combinations, and the load also varies, as you can see that. And then we use the maximum loading combination to design for each of the columns. To design for the pipe cap of each of the column, and also for the pie for each of the column, although we have to make a group of pies together. And also you can see that we followed all the rules for the principle of pie spacing, because when you're doing your pie foundation, you must first of all consider your pie spacing. Very, very important, because the reason why you must consider a pie spacing is because if your pie spacing does not conform to what is on the code of your design, then what happened is that during your design, you will not see it failing, but during the construction, then there'll be a major failure once they are done with the construction of that structure, because most of the pies will start to have cracks because they are too close to each other. Because when you pie this one here, now let me say they have pied this pie here, and then they have done they have also done this pie casting, and then if there's a pie just close to this place here, by the time they are piling another one here, that soil that is here will cause a very high pressure on this pie which is already pied, and then due to that pressure, it might cause a crack on this pie, which you might not know, because that is happening under the soil. So it is very, very good to space your pie using 3 times the pie diameter. Okay, so right now, for this lesson, I'll be showing you how to design a connecting pie, because by the time you are done with your pie cap design and also your pie design, you are meant to connect all the pie cap with a beam, okay? And that beam is called a connecting pie, or most of the times they call it a grid beam, okay? But the most common name is called connecting pie, okay? So right now, to begin our connecting pie, the first thing I'll do is to come here and click on this my layer first, and make my axis to be active. So right now I'll go then and then click on my concrete member and then choose concrete beam. Now the same procedure we use to design for our raft beam or for a strip beam is the same procedure we are going to use to design for this our pie cap connecting beams. Okay, so right now I will now go here and then choose my assumed pie pie cap connecting beam depth. So I will choose here to be 600 as my assumed, and then I'll leave this place as the width as what 225. And I'll leave everything here as default, and then I will now begin to now connect the pie caps together, just like this, by clicking on each of, I'll click here right now, and then click on the next pie cap here, and then release it, okay? And do the same thing again from here to here, and then continue with that, and then all the elements say there's a pie all the way down here, so I'll come here right now, and then click on this place here, it will just divide itself on the column, as you can see there right now. Okay, they'll be okay, that's fine. So I'll do the same thing again here by coming here, connect here. So the whole idea is to connect all your pie cap together. So let me just do that right now. I'll connect the whole pie cap now together. Okay, connect these two to this other one here. Okay, and then connect again this other one here to all the way down to this place here. Okay, So this is now right. Okay, that's fine. And I'll connect this again here from this point here to this point here. Okay. And then all the way down to, okay, no one here. And then from here to here. Okay. And again, from this point to this point. So the whole idea is to connect all the pie cap together. So I'll just quickly connect all of them now together and then come back to the video again. Okay, so I'll continue again by connecting this other one here and connect from this point to this point here. Okay, and then click on the escape key, just one escape key, and then connect from here again to this point here. Okay, and then connect again from this point of this pie to the end of this pie here, to this place here. Okay, and then I'll go again now and connect again this that one here, escape key, connect from this to this here. Okay, and then connect again from this to all the way down to this place here. Okay, and I'll connect again from this place to this place here. Okay, so why I'm doing that, I'll say that if you have not subscribed to our channel Ekidel, I'll say you should please click on the subscribe button so you don't miss our amazing videos on how to design structures. Okay, and also if you have already subscribed to our channel, I will say you should please recommend your friends and colleagues so that they also know what is happening here on Ekidel. Okay, so I'll do this also. Now if you want to know how to design a pie foundation, we have already done a comprehensive videos on that, and also how to design a pie cap. I will say that you can just register for our, join what they call our YouTube membership, and you'll be able to access all our design videos. Okay, so all our videos are all available for you to join our membership. Okay, so let me just connect this other one here. Okay, that's fine. And then connect again, connect again from here all the way down to this place here. So by the time you have joined or you have enrolled for our YouTube membership, you will be able to watch all our advanced and professional design videos. Okay, so you can just click on the join button below and then join our, and then be able to access all our amazing videos. Okay, so I'll click on this place again right now and then click here also, and then we will have done that. Okay, but if you want to know, if you want a one-on-one training, which we will use online training or Teams and also Google Meeting, then you will, then you can join our Ekidel mentorship class. Okay, we are about to train you specially. Now connect here again from here, so this is that one here. Okay, then I'll escape now and then connect again. I need to connect this to that side now. Let me see, all these places are okay and this place are okay, that's fine. And I'll connect again this to that side here. Yeah, this to the side from here all the way down to this place here. Okay, that's fine. Okay, so you can see that we are done with our pie cap connection. As you can see that we are done connecting all our pie cap with a beam. So let me just turn off this grid line so that you can see it very, very clear. So as you can see right now, we have done with the pie cap connection. As you can see that, so this is now what they call pie cap connecting beam. So you can see that we have just done the modeling of the pie cap connecting beams. So let me now show you the this 3D view of what we have just done so far. So you can now see that from this 3D view, now you can see that all our pie cap connecting beams now are now showing where all the pie caps are now being connected together with our connecting beam or with the grid beam, as you can see that. So the next thing now we are going to do right now is now going to design for this connecting beam, because what we just did is just the modeling. So we will now go and perform the design of this beam to see if the depth of that of this beam for what 600 is sufficient. Okay, so right now I'll have to go back to my plan view, but Before then, I would say that if you have not click on the subscribe button, I would say should please click on the subscribe button so that you don't miss our amazing videos on how to design structures. Because here on Ekidel, we train using real life examples, okay, and real life project, okay. Now, also on Ekidel, this month of September, which we're about entering, we are trying to put all our courses, all our course videos on our YouTube membership. So if you have been finding it difficult to download all our videos on our paid course videos, because we use a very high graphics to perform our paid course videos, so by you joining, or let me say joining our YouTube membership, you will be able to access all our course videos. So if you want to know more about how to design a pie foundation for a structure and the principle you're meant to follow using your soil bearing capacity and your soil test based on pi, and also if you want to know how to design a pie cap design, then I will say that you should click on the join button and join, and then enroll for our YouTube membership class, and then you will be able to know how to design most of these amazing most of these complex structures, like pie foundations, because not everyone that knows how to design a pie foundation. And also we explained a lot on that area, and also on our RAP foundations, we have done more videos on RAP foundations for free. On our paid video versions for RAP foundation, we explained a lot, like in the case of the slab raft. We explain a lot there because we have not done slab raft here, and also flat slab design. So those ones, those special designs, are what we do on our paid course videos, and we have added all of them to our YouTube membership. And we also have our videos on the platform Udemy. So if maybe you want to also follow us up to Udemy, you can also go and get our paid course there. Okay, so whichever it is free for you. And we also have our paid course done on our seller link website. You can get it all from there too. Okay, so right now, let's now go ahead to now go and design for this pie cap connecting beam for this building. Okay, so let's now move on to the next now.